Hey guys, so we're almost actually at the end of this little Mario clone. For now, anyway. I just wanna. What the heck is going on here? There we go. Live server. We're gonna make this Goomba interact with our Mario. We wanna just make it so that when this Mario runs into this Goomba, we're gonna we'll have a collision. So what I'm gonna do is go back to the game, and we'll go to the check collisions. And as this game is getting, this is a very, you know, straightforward, almost like non-Mario game so far, right? There's very little happening. There's no levels, there's no camera, we're not able to move off screen to a level, and yet it's a lot of code, so you can see why it's really helpful to organize things into these classes. And even this game class is getting a little bit out of hand here, so I would probably work to try and make it a little more orderly if we were going to continue. But we're almost done, so I'm not going to worry about it too much. But I just wanted to mention that. So in this collisions, we're going to, again, this time look for the Goombas. So for each Goomba, we're going to we'll run this function. We'll check if not this.goomba.defeated. So in other words, if it's defeated, we're not going to see it. We don't want to check this collision, because that wouldn't be fair. And then we'll see, just like we did up here above, we'll have if check Goomba collision. Collision. We'll check Goomba collision. We'll pass in this dot hero and this Goomba. So we're gonna check each one of these Goombas. And then if that thing returns true, then we'll console.log collided. Now I want to admit something here. I don't think I've in the version of this I made before I'm making these videos, right? I made a version of this because I don't code this fast. You know, I have to stop and think, and I just think that would be really boring for you to watch. This is already boring, probably. But I'm not super happy with my check Goomba collision function. And the reason for that is it feels like it doesn't always work perfectly. These coins probably don't work perfectly, but it feels like it works well enough when you're jumping around. The Goombas to me feel like there's some situations that I've tried it and they just didn't feel quite right. I haven't had time to sort of fine-tune that, but I just wanted to issue that mea culpa. And so it's something that if you leave some advice in the comments, I always appreciate that. Hero X plus hero.size. So just similar to what before, if we're going to say if the right-hand edge, and I'm going to, I'm not going to use the bounding box this time, but know that technique is out there for you if you need it. I just happen to know that's going to be 0.8, and I'm interested in hurrying this along at this point because I know these have been long videos. And we'll say hero.x is less than goomba.x plus goomba.size over 2. So if the hero.x is greater than the Goomba.x plus Goomba.size over 2. And that doesn't seem right. Here dot x is less than, that should be. Yeah. Less than Goomba dot x plus Goomba dot size over 2. Yeah, that's about right. Yeah, I think I must have played that and noticed that it was right. So if the hero, if the right edge of the hero-ish, the so-called right edge of the hero is greater than the beginning of the Goomba, or the left edge of the hero is less than the left side of the Goomba, because the Goomba is going to be moving towards the left. And we'll say, and hero.y plus hero.size, so the bottom of the hero is greater than hero.y, so that the y goes down the screen, right? So if the bottom of the hero is inside the Goomba. So these are the three directions we need to check. Never going to be underneath, because the hero can't go underground in this version of Mario. That could be something for you to try. So if those things are true, then we're going to return true. Else, we're going to return false. So let's see if we get a little just. Goombas is not a function at game 55. Okay. This dot Goombas for each Goomba. Yeah, there we go. Oops. Defeated. 56. This dot Goombas. We were seeing the Goombas before. That was nice. I liked that. Let's see. Render. Update. Did I not make the defeated property? Let's see here. Check collision. Oh, there we go. Not this dot Goomba. There we go. So that's going to refer to the Goomba that's being iterated over. That should do it. Okay, good. And we collided. Look at that. Collided a bunch. We just collided. Nice. So that looks pretty good. Now, we have to figure out what we're going to do when we collide. And what we're going to do is something like this. We're going to say if there was a Goomba collision, then we'll say if check collision winner. And again, we'll pass in this dot hero. So we're gonna write this function, and it's kind of a dumb function. But if the hero loses, then the game is gonna be over. And let's call this check. Hero wins, actually. Let's say check hero wins. We'll pass in hero, and so this is going to be down here. And I did this game before, but I'm also happy to revise it as I come up with like slightly better ideas. So Goomba.die. So if check hero wins this dot hero, then the Goomba will die. Otherwise, the game is over. So let's write this check hero wins function, right? Because we have determined that they're colliding. We haven't figured out who's won. So I'm going to just put this in here too. We'll say function check hero wins. And, you know, you notice I write these named functions Sometimes with the function keyword and sometimes with the arrow functions. If you're interested in knowing more about that, holler at me in the chat. It's a little bit of an interesting thing, but it's not that interesting a thing, so I don't want to necessarily bug you with it. Certainly not while we're busy trying to kill Goombas. So we'll call this hero wins. Check hero wins, hero. And we'll say, I think I'm just going to say, if this was the idea I had, because I was having a little bit of trouble trying to figure this out, how to make this work well. So I'm just going to say, if hero.y is greater than hero.startY, and I'm just going to say -1. So this means, like, if the hero's jumping, basically, because I was having a little trouble. I was going to see hero.jumping, but I don't know why that wasn't working too well for me. So if the hero's jumping, then hero wins, right? Okay, so that should be returned true. If hero.y is greater, so if the hero's up in the air, it's probably not high enough to actually win, but we'll see what it looks like. So else will return false. So if the hero's jumping, we'll return true. Otherwise, we'll return false. Let's see what it looks like. Oops, Goomba.die is not a function. Okay, so we need to do that. And in the Goomba, and that's a pretty, who doesn't like to make Goombas die? Actually, they look like mushrooms. They seem pretty cute. Here I am, I'm gonna kill them forever. I'm like the god of killing Goombas. So if the Goomba dies, then we wanna set the image to the squashed image, which in this will be the image at 0. Goomba, 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 Goomba. And then we'll say, we'll set that to that, and then set timeout. This dot defeated. Set defeated, sorry. And we'll set this to 200. So when it's defeated, then we won't see it anymore. And I think I maybe just figured something out. We'll set it immediately to disabled. And so we'll say, this is gonna be false. This dot disabled is false. And so we'll set defeated. And set defeated is just gonna be a function that's going to set defeated to true. But the reason I have that pause there is because we want to continue showing that image for like part of a second. And maybe we want to show it for even longer. But I just had that little brainstorm. If we set this dot disabled in our game, if not Goomba dot disable winning. So that might help a little bit. Oops. Oh, where's my start button? So I should have a little start button here, but that's good. We just got the game over. Showed our game over screen for the first time, which was nice. Unfortunately, when I went to my game over screen, there was no start button. And the reason for that is that we hit the start button. So we need to say this dot start button dot show. Nice. Let me just think about if there's anything else we need to do here when we end the game. I think there are a few other things we need to do, and I think it might be best to do those. Actually, we'll do those in a whole other video. So let's just make sure we get our start button showing. Oh, I just killed him. That wasn't very fun. I guess, Mario always wins in this version. We gotta make him die. got this if then wrong. Nope. Let's see. Okay, so I did it. I reversed it, I think. Hero, check hero wins. This dot hero. So if that's true, then the Goomba should die. Otherwise, we'll game over. And check hero wins. Takes in the hero. And if the hero dot y is less than. All right, if it's greater than hero dot start y, then this should be false. That means the hero did not win. Hey, game over. Now, that's an extremely unsatisfying game over animation, but... Huh. All right, so we're going to have to fix that in the next game as well, because that should start a new game. So that'll be something to do in the next video. Let's just see if this works. Oh, I died again. And... Ah! Now I can't... Ah! I was mentioning that this has been pretty unsatisfying to get this right. Okay, so now I was well over the Goomba. I'm going to have to pause this video and figure out what I'm doing wrong, because I don't want to waste your time. But maybe you can figure it out, and I'll certainly figure it out in the next video.